Hello, this is Evangelist Dr. Robert L. McKim, Sr. from Carrollton, Ohio. I found another tape recording where I was talking to Pina Meek, and she does not know nothing about, she does know nothing about what's going on between my dad and her daughters. And she even states that she owns her own home and she does not want nothing to do with dad's home. I'll play it and let you hear it.
Hello. How are you today?
Not too happy.
What's wrong, honey?
Well, I got a call from Barb last night. She said that I was making threats to Dad.
Well, your dad's not here for you to talk to him, honey. He left today.
And anyhow, I just wanted to clear it up. I wasn't threatening Dad. I was just trying to tell him I wasn't happy with, what he's been telling me, and that, nobody's going to be stealing his home from him.
Honey, I don't even know what you're talking about.
The title situation to his house trailer. All he's been telling me is that basically Mary's been, either putting her name on the title or your name on the title. That's what he's been telling me.
I honestly do not know anything about what you're talking about. If he's doing anything like that, I don't know it.
Well, see, that's the thing. My dad says one thing, then he turns around and says something else. Him and my mother both were like that all the time. Me and, of course, Barb was married. And even before, my mom would always lie to rob Peter to pay Paul, things of that nature. And there's, I guess they think a white lie won't hurt, but it does hurt. Or saying one story and turn around and saying a different story. But if it's not the truth, it does hurt.
Well, honey, like I said, I haven't heard your dad say that stuff.
Well,
I don't think he says it around here, or I would probably know about it.
And then he told me about the situation where he was crying, and your daughter Patty and the other girls up there at the, in Strasburg at Patty's trailer, reported that Dad is hitting you.
Who told you that?
Dad told me that.
Honey, none of my kids have ever laid a hand on me.
No, not them. They had reported that my dad, had been hitting you.
Oh boy. Well, hang on, I'll have
I said, you know, for one thing, you know, if we change to a tour from him, yeah, you know, Florida does have a stand your ground law, and I won't stand for it. And if push comes to shove, you know, someone will be getting hurt. And then on top of that, I told him that it would probably be best to not just have his name on the title, but also to put my name on the title, not so that I can take his trailer from him, but so when anything ever happens to him, that it's easier on me to, you know, be able to take care of the mobile home down there instead of going through the welfare and the court system.
Well, here's the way I look at all that. Your dad is a very intelligent man, and I think he'll do what he wants to do regardless of you, me, or anybody else.
I know he thinks more about himself, really, when it comes right down to it.
But like I'm saying, he has not said anything to me about putting names on the trailer or nothing else. I don't even know what you're talking about.
Well, Barb, she called me last night on my cell phone and bitched me out and told me to stop threatening people, and I'm like, I told her what, I said, I even told Bobby, you know, because I was talking to Bobby about the, you know, the title situation, because Brad said, at one point in time, Bobby was down there with him, too, at the courthouse to get the title, and, anyhow, and I guess Mary, she had the title on her, and she's supposed to be sending it up, and at one point in time, Dad says he hasn't got it yet, then he said he got it, yeah, that's what he told me yesterday, he got the title, and, Mary had put your name on the title too, but his name.
Well, I don't know, but I'll tell you, whatever your dad does, I have my own home. I own my own home. I have never wanted that trailer out from under him. And what he does, I look at it this way. That man is an adult. He's going to do what he wants to do, and you know your dad, and you know that's what he does.
Yeah, I know. He's as stubborn as my mom's dad was.
Well, he told me point blank, he's going to do what he chooses to do.
And then he said something about he might just sell it and rent somewhere.
Well, I haven't heard that, but I feel this way. That is his home. What he does with it is none of my business. That is his decisions, not mine. And there's no way that I will try and influence him, no matter what he does. Here's the way I look at it. I own my own home. I live where I'm at now. What he does is his business. Now that's how I look at it. That man is a grown adult. Not only that, he's a lot smarter than people give him credit for. And what he does, he has made it quite clear. What he wants to do, he's going to do. And that's exactly what he has told me.
Hurts a lot, and that's basically because Ohio weather is more damp, you know, more humidity.
I know that.
Been down in Florida, and when he said he was in Florida, he didn't hurt as much.
And he didn't.
And, you know, I understand why he moved to Florida, so he don't have to hurt so much.
I know that.
But it worries me, too, about him down there by himself, and if anything happens to him, then, you know, it's going to be a big headache on me. Now, there's going to be a lot of people fighting over his stuff, and it's...
Who do you think is going to be fighting over his stuff?
Bobby and Barb.
Oh, boy. Well, I'm not trying to talk to him, but you know yourself, your dad can be pretty stubborn, and he is going to do, and he is going to say what he wants to do.
I know.
And the way I look at it, he's a very intelligent man. He's a grown adult, and I have no right to tell him what to do.
I know, but my mother, when she was living, her grandmother, my great-grandmother, they both had Tupperware parties. And my mom bought a lot of Tupperware bowls and other Tupperware things. And, of course, you know, me being little at the time, too, I was there at the Tupperware parties. So I remember the Tupperware parties. And by when my mother was living, she, you know, mentioned to me that she wanted me to have the Tupperware bowls. And when everything happened to her and Dad both, and then there was that situation when Dad was moving out of the trailer down there in Newcomers Town. Well, it got mixed up. Dad said that the bowl was supposed to go to Bobby, and they, I guess, thought it was, supposed to go to, you know, my son Bobby, and of course Dad got mad and went back down to Barb's and got the bowls back, and then now it's like he doesn't, you know, want to give him up at all. And you know what I mean? It's just a lot of things have happened that, you know, contradicts what had been told to me in the past, and all because of other people, you know, getting involved.
Honey, what other people?
Well, you know, when they were cleaning out Dad's trailer down there, everybody that was involved in that. I guess Patty was down there. I'm not sure who all was down there. Bobby and Barb, and I'm not sure who all was down there cleaning up the trailer.
I'm not either. I'm not sure who we're always down there, but I'll tell you this. I will talk to your dad. I will listen to exactly what he says. And as far as doing what he wants, that's exactly what I'll do.
I know he wants you to go back down there with him when he goes, and he says that you probably won't be allowed.
Honey, he told me not too long ago that he wanted to go down there by himself.
See, that's what I'm saying. He tells me one thing, and then he turns around and tells you something else. Other people other things. And did he tell you about someone backing into his truck at Walmart?
Oh, yeah. And I saw it, and they did back into it.
Well, I stopped at Walmart.
I mean, I didn't see the actual accident.
Yeah.
But he has a place where he was hit.
I was talking to Walmart, and they do own the parking lot. It's considered as private property, you know, because it's a, you know, it's not on the public street, you know what I mean? And they, I was telling when did that happen? Saturday?
Did Bob say anything in front of you about the accident, he said, where
could see the video cameras, because they videotaped the parking lot. But they said that basically that since that is private property, a police report has to be made whenever someone's vehicle is hit in the parking lot. And I was telling Dad, I asked him, did he do a police report? Oh no, I don't want my insurance rates to go up.
That's what he told me.
It won't be his insurance I'll pay for. It'll be the other person's insurance. It won't make his rates go up. It'll make the other guy's rates go up.
Well, I'll try and talk to him, but that does not... I don't know if it'll do me a bit of good.
I know, and he don't listen to me either.
Your dad does, plain and simple, what he wants to do.
I know.
And the way things are, I have no idea what he might do. I don't know. And right now, he don't even want to talk about it.
That's what he
told me.
And he told me he's all shook up about it. He said, boy, I won't go to Walmart ever again. I'll go to Aldi's.
That's what he told me.
Well, let me tell you, I was at Walmart, just a little while ago when I got back home a little bit ago, and I had to run down there and to Dover and talk to the doctors and make sure I get the right kind of stuff called into the drugstore, and then I went to Aldi's, got some more milk while it was on sale, and went down to Walmart to talk to them, and then while I was leaving Walmart, there was this one vehicle that's parked in front of the grocery store part of Walmart, letting some Amish women out. And then they were getting ready to move their vehicle, and here comes this big red full-size van passing that vehicle, and they're not yielding like they're supposed to yield, you know what I mean, or anybody. Said New Philadelphia, Ohio on the window of the van, so I'm not sure if it was a school van or a van for the city or what, but people drive crazy in the parking lot. They don't want to wait for anybody.
Yeah, you're right about that. And it happens all the time, too, not just once in a while.
I know it happens all the time.
Where your dad is concerned, right now he's not here. I have no idea where he went or when he'll be back.
Alright, well, maybe he wants to talk to me. It's up to him.
I'll tell him you called and tell him what you said. And right now, whatever he wants to do, I made up my mind, I'm leaving it up to him.
Yeah,
it won't do me a bit of good to try and tell him what to do, and I don't do that anyway.
Because
that man makes it clear, he makes those decisions.
I know.
So, that's the way things are right now. But I will tell him you called, and I hope he'll call you back.
Well, I'm not too happy with him or whoever called Barb last night.
Oh, was it me?
No, someone called Barb last night because she called me.
Well, honey, I know nothing about what it might have been or anything else.
Well, she called me and told me to stop threatening my dad and threatening people.
Oh, boy. Like I said, I really don't know what's going on. I couldn't tell you.
Okay.
So, well, tell Renee I love her. I'll let you know.
She's been laying down. She's not feeling good.
Oh, no.
All right. Talk to you later.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
That was a long conversation, so this will be a long video. As you heard, she does not want nothing to do with dad's trailer. But, oh man, in his will, she has his dad's trailer. Actually, her daughter's has dad's trailer. And if you heard what I said about the title, Mary went and put penis name on the title. Not my dad. My dad had nothing to do with that. Mary put her mother's name on the title. My dad, according to his neighbor lady down there, they went to the courthouse to see what they can do about getting her name off the title. Dad just won his name on the title. It would be $350 to get another title. He didn't have the money at the time. So he just let it go. You see how dirty and sneaky Pina's daughters are? If that doesn't say anything about that will should be voidable, then nothing is. This conversation and the other conversation that I had with my dad, if these two conversations isn't proof enough to make that will voidable that he made in 2010, leaving everything to Pina and giving nothing to me and the grandkids, great-grandkids. If these conversations doesn't mean anything, then we are living in a world that where the law doesn't care about the truth. God bless you. Have a blessed day.